So as soon as I see that it's got sine of 2x, what comes to mind is that sine of 2x is equal to 2 sine of x times cosine of x, which at first seems like a good thing to use since it's asking for sine of x. But the problem is we've got that sine of 2x equals 2/3, so we would be looking at this. 2/3 equals 2 times sine times cosine. Or you could divide by 2 and have 1/3 equals sine times cosine. But that just says I've got two things, I multiplied them together, and I got 1/3. There's actually an infinite number of ways you can do that, so it doesn't really narrow down what sine or cosine is equal to, only what their product is equal to. So we need to start somewhere else. Well, we also have identities for cosine of 2x, like for example, 1 minus 2 sine squared of x. And so we could then do some algebra to solve for sine of x, get rid of the 1, divide by negative 2, take the square root, if we knew what cosine of 2x was equal to. Well, we can do that by using this and the idea that this is telling us two sides of a triangle. So here is the angle 2x. Sine is opposite over hypotenuse. So we now have two sides of the triangle. And then we need to solve for this side down here using the Pythagorean theorem. So b squared plus 2 squared equals 3 squared. So we're going to have a 4 subtracted from both sides. So this will be a 9, and then subtract 4. Nine subtract 4 is a 5. And then take the square root of 5. Usually we would say plus or minus the square root so that we could figure out, well, depending on what quadrant this is in, should it be positive or negative? But there's no quadrant given, so I'm just going to use the positive as a default. Now I can figure out from this triangle what cosine of 2x is equal to. So cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, so that's going to be the square root of 5 over the hypotenuse of 3. And now put the two ideas together. So on the one hand, we have this formula. On the other, we have that cosine of 2x is equal to this fraction. So substitute that right over here. Or take that one and substitute over here. So 1 minus 2 sine squared of x is equal to the square root of 5 over 3. We've then just got three steps of algebra. Subtract 1 from both sides. Which actually causes an extra step of algebra because we need a common denominator here. So this can be rewritten as 3 over 3. So the exact answer is going to look like the square root of 5 minus 3 over 3. And then we can divide by negative 2. So that's going to move a negative 2 to the denominator, making this a negative 6. So the square root of 5 minus 3 over a negative 6. And then take the square root. So sine is going to be the square root. And then it's square root of 5 minus 3 over negative 6. And now I want to go back to this idea that this could be positive or negative the square root. And at first I said we weren't given a quadrant, so I'll just leave it positive. Now I'm thinking maybe I should just be as accurate as possible and throw in the positive or negative every time I do a square root. Besides, it makes a pretty cool looking answer.